Hello you all, welcome back to my channel. If you are returning subscriber, what's good? If you are new, hey, well, I am back with another video, okay? So, I wanted to come and talk about fighting the spirit of lust on your walk, okay? Now, I have talked about lust a few times on my channel. I don't feel like I've really talked about it as often as I should, but I feel like when it comes to lust, that's kind of like a hidden sin that some people like to have. Some people don't want others to know that they are battling with something like this. Some people live openly with a spirit of lust, and some people live secretly with a spirit of lust. And lust is an extremely powerful sin, and it can be something shameful to talk about. But when you constantly get this tug and pull that you need to speak on something, that's just what you do. And so that's why I'm talking about this right now. And there are some people out here that fear speaking on this topic. Okay, so much fear and shame behind the spirit of lust as well. But my thing is, you shouldn't be fearful of anything. Okay, when you are walking in truth and you are walking with the Lord, no topic is really off limits. And I have always been the type of person that whatever you fear the most, you shall go towards, okay? Whatever you feel the most shall surely come upon you, okay? And so when you have a fear of something, you have to conquer that fear. That's the only way you are going to be able to fight it successfully. You are really going to be fighting with a strong spirit of lust on your walk. Just when you feel as though you are close to your destination, okay? That spirit of lust is going to creep in and make you fall 10 or 20 steps back, and it's so many things that can reignite this spirit. And when you become closer with Christ, you are going to have a better understanding of this, because we are living in a very over sexualized world. And you might have been at one point to where you was a part of that, and now that you have chosen a totally different direction, you just see things completely different. And you have a better understanding as to why this is a dangerous sin, why this sin is so powerful. It's one of the most fleshly kind of spirits and sins that you could ever fight up against. It's inner spiritual warfare and outer spiritual warfare, depending on where the spirit is manifested. And see, this is a thing. When you are fighting against this spirit, something is going to make you feel convicted, okay? Your thoughts, your actions, how you move through life. The way that you are going to know that you are close with Christ is when you constantly feel a spirit of conviction whenever lust presents itself in your life, okay? You are going to feel filthy, nasty, you know, all of that. It's something going to feel unsettled with your spirit when you see certain things. And before, it probably wasn't a problem because you was probably indulging in the spirit of lust, okay? But now that you are closer with the Lord, it's completely different. It's almost as if you know that this is wrong. And having a spirit of lust, the book of Genesis, where Adam and Eve ate from the tree that the Lord forbade them to stay away from, and they was kind of running and hiding themselves with bushes and leaves and things like that because they was just in a bare nakedness. And I know you probably like, what they got to do with this? When you are fighting the spirit of lust, it's a very shameful kind of sin. When you do certain things in the dark, lust is a very dark sin. A lot of things that are dealing with the lust is done in darkness. And so it would be in a sense where you feel as though you are running and hiding yourself. Like the spirit of lust is just kind of like that person that, and I'm going to just use some precise examples. This is why I stopped going to church a long time ago, and I don't follow men, I follow the Lord, you know, when it comes to being on this walk. And it's just kind of like when you're fighting the spirit of lust, and I have seen this so many different times in the body of Christ, certain spiritual leaders, certain pastors, deacons, you know, people that are in that high position, I have seen them battle with this sin, and it really just made me look at things completely different, because I've had times to where, and this is just me being completely transparent with y'all, I was in this sin a long time ago. But the one thing I could say I noticed was, it used to be a lot of pastors and deacons that would be in my inbox, and I always thought it was kind of strange, because these men would be married, and I know this whole culture, like I said, everything seemed to be over sexualized out here. But if I was the type of woman that was with that, if I was the type of woman that didn't care that he was married, there have been times to where I've been in my flesh, but not to the point to where I would stoop so low and try to be with a pastor or a deacon. I look at the pastor and the deacon, that's the man of the cloth. And so even when I was out here in the world and I was operating in that spirit, I still had enough respect for myself, enough to know not to mess around with the man of God. Okay, I ain't never been the type to ever try to exploit someone's weakness. It just never really felt right to me. Even though I was in that position to where I could have done that, it just has never been in my spirit to do so. Even when I was out here in the world, I still had enough morality to know which man was off limits, which man's not to date. And like I said, when it comes to the man of the cloth, even though this man may not be following what he is preaching, I still have enough respect for myself, and I hold the Lord to a high regard. Even when I was out here sinning, I still had enough respect to not mess with the man of God. Okay, even though he is not living up to his position, I would never mess around with him, because that would be like spitting in the Lord's face. You know, hopefully y'all understand what I'm trying to say. I grew up in a church. I've seen this my entire life, so I would never, even when I was out here sinning, I still had enough respect for myself, enough to know not to mess with someone's husband, not to mess with the man of the cloth. It doesn't matter. And then, see, this is where you see a lot of women take advantage, but we're going to get into that a little later on in the video. When you see this sin and you see who is being used by this sin, it can be a very eye-opening spiritual experience. But I've seen so many men kind of play around with this thing, and it's almost in a sense to where they feel as though they are powerful, as if they are untouchable because they hold this position. And when I say untouchable, I'm talking about from both sides of the spectrum. They feel like they are untouchable by the Lord, and they feel like they are untouchable by Satan. Okay, it's really kind of like that shame, that wanting to be in the dark, not want to tell nobody about what's going on. Like, you know, you got a wife, you know, you got a family, but you trying to mess around behind your wife's back. You trying to take me out on dates. You trying to meet up with me. And see, this the thing. Let me just say this first and foremost. I ain't never messed with nobody's husband. I ain't never slept with no pants, no deacon, none of that type of stuff. But I have had them approach me before, and I can't already tell that I'm probably not the only woman that they have tried this with. They probably sleeping with other women. If they are battling with a sin like this, you know, they are in this position where they're supposed to be practicing what they preach, okay? And they are doing the total opposite of what the Bible speaks against, then that kind of lets you know where we are at as a society when it comes to fighting this spirit of lust. And it's just kind of like that whole thing of trying to do something without getting caught, and then you trying to hide yourself, just like, you know, eating from the tree that the Lord forbid you to stay away from. Like, you know, lust is an evil sin, and you know that the Bible speaks against this, you preach about this, and so for you to then turn around and do the total opposite of what you preached about, it's very telling. That's why the Lord tells us, don't put your trust and faith in man, put your trust in me. And so that's why I always come and tell y'all that just because a person is picking up their Bible does not mean that they are living what they are preaching. It's so many people that are professing the Lord's name, but they are not walking in his name. They are not living for him. You know, they are trying to cover themselves up. And so in a sense, in this video, we are talking specifically about lust. We talked about envy and all those types of sins, but we are going to talk about lust specifically because I have seen so many people battling with this, and I see it even stronger now that I have been on my walk with Christ. And since I know that I'm not operating in spirit no more, there's been times to where the spirit has been presented to me. Okay, it's strong, but I want to live for the Lord. I want to walk with Christ. I don't want to be weak to lust. I don't want something taking over my flesh. I don't want something evil taking over me. Lust is evil. And it took me years to realize that this was an evil sin. You know, when people are operating in the spirit of lust, they're comfortable in it. They don't care. You know, they just living their lives freely, just whatever. They don't see the wrong in the era of what they are doing. But really, it is a sin. And if you don't fight it, there's going to be destruction. There's nothing godly about the spirit of lust. Lust is very dark. And a lot of people are victim to it because it feels good to the flesh, you know? And so when I come and speak in a sense about people hiding themselves, when it comes to that pastor messing around, I'm just talking about what's real, okay? You don't really have to know a person personally to know what they indulge in. When you see how they move, that's gonna let you know everything. But the spirit of lust is just kind of like the same thing as picking up that Bible and preaching to a whole congregation, and then after you are going to hop in different women DMs on IG and things like that. Like, how can you sit up and preach in front of a lot of people and then turn around and do the very opposite of what you just said? That's why you should always put your trust and faith in not in man. And when it comes to this whole lust thing, it's kind of like that. Oh, let me do this. Try to see if I can get away with it. It's just kind of like, y'all gonna think this is weird the way I'm gonna say this, but hopefully y'all following me. When the man of a cloth is battling with a lustful spirit, matter of fact, I'm not gonna even say battling with a spirit of lust. You are willingly dabbling in this sin. You are willingly, you're not even trying to fight this sin. You just don't care. And you have no restraint over your flesh. You have let the enemy take over. That pastor playing around with the spirit of lust, he's just kind of like that uncle or that father or that, you know, that person that touched you when you was a child. You know, they tried to get away with it and they tried to hide it. You know, shh, be quiet, don't tell nobody, and things like that. That's just, every time I see a man of the cloth playing around with this sin like this, I look at it in that sense. Is that pedophile? Because it's just kind of like, why would you play around with, like, you know what you are doing is wrong. It makes no sense. And when I see things like this, it don't do nothing but make me draw more closer to the Lord, because I just see so many people falling victim to this spirit. I even see it with women too. Like, when it comes to the man of the cloth, seems as though certain women, I have seen this so many, like, I've been seeing it since I was a child too. Whenever a woman see a man that is in so much of a powerful position, it's just kind of like this spirit come over her. I've seen it. It's weird the way I describe it, but I have seen so many times to where women just willingly go after a married man, like, you know, a pastor. You know, he's been with First Lady for how long? And you coming to church, you ain't trying to come and get no word. You trying to come and see him. You have a lustful sin. You want to be with this man. Some of these women may be married themselves. Some of them may be in relationships. They may be single. Like I said, that's why I stopped going to church so long ago, because it was so much foolery I would see in the church. Like, it would be so much lust going on in the church. People are not really there to get a word from the Lord. They are there to get themselves off, in a sense. They are coming to feed their lust by coming to see this man. This man ain't got to be touching you in order for you to be getting your fix, in a sense. Okay, that's kind of like what it is with the spirit of lust. Like, when you go to church and you ain't trying to get a word from the Lord, you are coming for a different agenda. You are looking at this man in a very lustful way. You putting up a facade, you putting up a front. You know that this man is married. You know that he is basically off limits. So why are you coming with a different agenda? Why are you not coming to hear a word from the Lord? Like, this man, and I'm not saying every man in the body of Christ, every pastor, every apostle, every prophet, every man that holds this position. I'm not saying that all of them are no good, because some men, you can tell, they are on fire for the Lord. They have a strong faith and belief and lead his people in the right direction. They don't have no evil agenda. They're not trying to play around with fire. You know, you got some people that will willingly play around with fire. These are the type of people that are daredevils. Like, they will literally hold the Bible and then turn around and do sin 10 or 15 minutes later, knowing very well that it's wrong. They don't care about the consequences. They already feel like they are covered because they are the quote-unquote man of cloth, or they are holding a certain position, when really you have a assignment that you failed to do. And so it's going to be consequences behind it. But what I'm saying is, I have seen times where women will try to go after a pastor specifically, okay? And this is where I never really came on my channel and talked about this, but this is where the spirit of Jezebel comes in at. And you kind of see where women willingly go after a pastor. This woman knows this man's weakness because she is willingly walking into sin. Okay, she carries a very lustful spirit, and she want to go after this man. She already know he married. See, a lot of people, we're going to talk about this from a different aspect. When it comes to being on this walk with Christ and really walking with the Lord, not walking with men, okay? It's okay to take guidance from other people, but who are you taking guidance from? Is this person really walking with the Lord? You are going to be able to tell. But some people can tell when people are weak. Some people can see spirits are real. We are all spirits in the flesh. Spirits know what you are battling up against. They know that you are weak in certain areas. And so this is in the sense of what I spoke about on my channel, where I said some people deem believers in Christ to be people that are naive, you know, people that are gullible. And I have to come and say that is very true, because people come and quote this scripture, be wise as a serpent, harmless as a dove. But it's really a lot of people out here that are extremely naive and gullible in the body of Christ, okay? And that spirit of lust and that evil spirit, whatever type of spirit that you are battling with, that spirit gonna come present itself to you because it knows that you are weak. You are prey. It don't matter what powerful position that you are holding. If you are not walking with the Lord, this spirit already know that. This is why I come in. I speak against overly religious people, because they be putting up so many facades. They be trying to act so holier than thou. These holier than thou people be the main ones to be in church. And I'm coming to tell the truth on Sunday. Okay, tell the truth and shame the devil. Okay, we are talking about the spirit of lust on Sunday. It's a lot of people that go to church just so they can see the pastor, just so they can get their rocks off. They already know that this man is married. They being fake with first lady the whole time. They want first lady men and stuff like that. It be all type of stuff going on. And these be the type of women that always be throwing and casting stones at other women, always trying to look down their nose at certain people, point their finger at other people. And they're operating in the spirit of lust secretly, okay? You got some people out here that's living comfortably with the spirit of lust, and some people are living secretly. And that's how these holier than thou, overly religious kind of people be. They be trying to act as though they don't be doing certain things when really they be doing it in secret, okay? And they want to come and try to turn their nose up at people and judge and talk about people, talk about certain women. This is why I say I don't come and judge nobody. That's why I don't have nothing on my channel. I know I used to be a woman that was operating very strongly with the spirit of lust. Okay? I'm not coming. I'm not trying to have that. I'm not trying to act as though I'm perfect, that I never had sex before, that I never had a sexual thought before, that I never had a strong spirit of lust before. Like I said, some people are ashamed to sin. They don't want people to know that they carry this can of sin. Okay? But since I'm walking with the Lord and I'm walking in truth, and I know that I am not weak to this sin anymore, I can speak openly about this, about everything that I have ever seen coming up, all the way up until now. You know, even from being in a church, we're gonna talk about social media too, how I have seen it so many times on social media. But these holier than thou women be the main ones that be fighting with this spirit of lust in secret. They be trying to act like they so pure, when really they be doing a lot of dirt behind the scenes. they be judging certain women for how they be dressed and how they be looking and stuff. And let me just say this. This is why you should never judge a book by its cover. Let me clear this up real quick before we even get deep into the message, okay? These overly religious people that's probably listening to this video and they probably gonna want to hop in the comments. Let me just clear this up for you real quick, okay? I do know the difference between dressing modestly and dressing worldly. It is true that people do perceive you a certain way by the way that you are dressed, but a lot of times y'all be wrong when y'all be pointing y'all fingers down at certain women. They may dress a certain way. Some of these women ain't out here like that. Some of these women ain't even out here doing nothing, okay? They may dress a little more scantily clad, but y'all want to call these women whores and say they sleeping around and things like that, point the finger. And see, this is the thing about being overly religious. These holier than thou women, a lot of them carry a very envious, jealous spirit. And I have seen this a lot too over the years. They be jealous of a certain kind of woman, okay? And so they want to make their judgments and point their fingers and try to call this woman all type of whores, and when really you don't know this woman. This woman ain't out here like that. And let me just say this, I know I'm finna hit somebody with this. The woman that you are talking about that's so whorish, she don't even get down like that. She don't do stuff like that. She be turning men down left and right. You jealous of her because she got the ads and attention of somebody in the body of Christ, the man of the cloth. This woman probably is trying to come and get her deliverance. She don't carry no lustful spirit. You don't want to carry a lustful spirit. And because you know that this man got ads for this woman, you jealous and you envious of that, okay? That's why you coming to point your finger at this woman. That's why you calling her all type of whores and things like that. You don't even know this woman. This woman ain't no whore. Okay, you the one that's mad because she getting a certain kind of attention from this man that you want. Okay, this woman don't even want this man, but you want him though. That's why you jealous, and that's why you point your finger at this woman, and that's why you looking down your nose, and that's why you spreading words of gossip within the church. Okay, this ain't nothing that I didn't deal with personally. This is things that I have seen other people deal with, okay? And so y'all gotta chill with the whole thing of pointing your fingers and turning your nose up and judging people, when really the fingers that you point at other people is far more pointing back at you. And a lot of y'all that are be acting holier than thou, y'all know what y'all be doing behind the scenes. Y'all know y'all be coming to church for the pastor. You be the one to be coming to the church for the pastor. Tell the truth for shame, the devil. You think just because you are fully covered from neck up on down to your feet, that don't nobody see that lustful spirit on you. That don't nobody see that envious spirit on you. It don't matter what you're wearing. It matters about the heart and the spirit that you are carrying. Appearance is only a piece of who you are. It is not your identity, okay? And so let me just say that. But yeah. People in the body of Christ, I have seen this so many different times. Women be coming to church for a man. A lot of women are on this walk to try to get them a man. They ain't trying to grow closer with Christ. Okay? People be going to church for other reasons. And they ain't gonna come on here and tell you that. They gonna be praising the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. All in front of your face. But behind the scenes, they trying to flirt with the pastor, the deacon, knowing that this man got a wife. They trying to be fake with first lady whole time. They crushing on her man, trying to get with her man. That's why they always at church. They always at every event. They trying to get closer to their pastor. Okay? So yeah, we telling the truth and shame the devil on Sunday. But yeah, it's a very strong spirit of lust within the body of Christ. It's in the church. It's outside of the church. It's on social media. It's a whole bunch of pastors online. Okay? And see, this is another thing I've been noticing too. A lot of people are trying to place titles on themselves because they know this is what draw women in. Okay? You got a lot of people out here trying to fake like they're a pastor. And they have been called to do a certain thing for the Lord. When really they are trying to get this position so that they can't reel in women. Okay? They know there's a few women out here that's going to be ready to drop them draws for the man of the cloth. Okay? A lot of them. Holier than thou and worldly kind of women, as they would say, are going to be ready to drop their draws for this pastor. So that's why they are trying to hop on the bandwagon of trying to come be a pastor or apostle or prophet, whatever you want to call it. Because they want to exploit people's weaknesses at the same time exploiting their own weaknesses, the spirit of lust.
Okay? You can tell when a person is really walking with Christ and when a person is coming with a different agenda. Okay? You see women doing this type of thing too. Putting themselves in certain positions so that they can get a certain kind of attention. Okay? I done seen that before too. I done seen it in the church. I done seen it on social media. I done seen it out in real life. All of that. Okay? So, if you are battling a spirit of lust, you have to pray to the Lord about it. You have to grow closer with Christ. You have to follow the Lord and not men, because everybody is human. Okay? This is not to say that you are an evil person because you are battling with this sin, because we are all human. You put this lustful spirit on the altar. Okay? You ask the Lord to remove this spirit from within you. You want to grow closer with Him. When you put your faith in man and not the Lord, you're going to fall victim to the spirit of lust. You're going to be deceived. If you are not coming for the right intentions on this walk with Christ, it's going to be revealed. People are going to be able to see your spirit. You can't have behind no Bible. You can't have behind no pulpit. You can't have behind none of that type of stuff. If your spirit is not right, people are going to be able to see it. It don't matter what type of title that you carry. Okay? So if it's something that you're battling with, you take it over to the Lord. So it's just what I want to come and talk about with y'all this morning. I want to have a little morning talk with y'all about the spirit of lust. I've been dancing around this topic as well. This is going to be something that I'm going to be speaking about more on my channel. Okay? But yeah. Ain't no reason for you to point the finger at nobody. We ain't perfect out here. If you are battling with the spirit of lust, take it over to the Lord in prayer. Pray to the Lord about it. You are not a bad person because you are battling with this spirit. That don't make you an evil person. If you have a fear of this sin, if you feel like you are falling victim to it, take it to the Lord in prayer. Ask the Lord to remove any lustful thought, any lustful things. Okay? The Lord is going to work wonders within you when you are walking with Him. For real. Not fake. Okay? When you are for real walking with the Lord, you are going to be able to defeat the spirit of lust with no problem. Okay? You're going to have some problems in the beginning on your walk, but once you grow stronger with Him, fighting that spirit of lust is going to be like nothing. It's going to be so easy. You are going to be able to spot it in other people. You are going to know who you don't need to be taking no messages from, who you don't need to be taking no guidance from, who church you don't need to be going to, all of that type of stuff. Okay? Being on this walk with the Lord, it's about being on this walk with Him. Okay? It's all about you and your growth at the end of the day. And it don't matter what nobody else got to think about it, because at the end of the day, you got to answer to the man upstairs. And that's all that matters, okay? So put that spirit of lust on the altar and turn your life over to Christ. And hopefully y'all got something from this video. Hopefully it helped you in some way. Continue to protect y'all's own spirit. And I will talk to y'all in the next video.